Good morning, everyone. William with the Wendy's here, Lance and Flo, and you see Ruby is behind me, and we are airing down today. We are heading out to do chicken corners here in Moab, and you see that we're here with our friends, Todd and Kim, and they have a nice setup. Love their Jeep. Love that color. So it's a beautiful day here. It's supposed to be in the low 90s. So we figured we get out today, hit chicken corners. Right. It's a beautiful trail, not super hard. It's moderate. You got some shelves, pretty high shelves. But we're going to take you along on our adventure today with Ruby. All right, so we just started on the trail. As you can see, there's nothing too complicated, nothing too hard about it. But look at these views. They're just stunning. It's beautiful, the walls. Now you do have shelves, you know, just gotta, as you can see here. And I heard on the trail, the further you go back on the trail, there's steeper shelves. So, let's just show you this. Look at those walls, they're just beautiful. My video and pictures are just not going to capture the beauty of this. It's very beautiful. So we made a quick stop here, photo opportunity, as you can see. But would you look at it? It's just amazing here. Beautiful views. Just epic. Beautiful. There's our friends.
So it's not an arctic anymore.
Beautiful. And not many people are out here. But just look at it. I'm in awe. It's going to be an amazing trail for beautiful views. Got a nice breeze in the air.
Awesome.
Kim. Come in. We're stopping here just to take in the views. Desert. Look how beautiful these elderflowers are. We had to stop and check them out. So pretty. We saw this pretty section of blooming cactuses. Look at these. They're just so pretty. Gotta watch our walk. And look at these yellow ones. This was a great photo opportunity for us all. So, it's beautiful. Keep going. You got it. beautiful here. Stopped here. Look at this pretty cool chicken corner quirky thing. Oh wow, this is pretty cool. This is beautiful. Beautiful through here. believe it or not, this is our epic lunch spot. Yeah, I guess. You got the Colorado River there.
Yeah,
you got
we'll
some.
Take it.
Oh.
If this is the best it gets.
I know. There's Lance. Say hi, Lance.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
Oh, this trail.
This little arch, kind of.
Yeah. This trail was amazing, and we get to go back and see it at a different viewpoint. There were a few obstacles, nothing major. Both her Jeeps did wonderful, didn't rub, didn't scrape. There they are. There's some rocks here. But yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah, so we're gonna sit here and take a little break, get some water, and take this all in before we start heading back to Moab. We just had a little break here, had some lunch. There's Lance there relaxing. Kim. There's the Jeeps. Everybody left. It's pretty quiet and peaceful. We're just taking in the moment here. It's just beautiful. Colorado River there. Some of the rocks. Pretty cool. Now we gotta head back. It's an out and back trail. So we're gonna go back the same way. Jeeps. All right, testing a little bit of Ruby's flexing.
But we're better here now.
Yeah.
We were squished in there before.
Yeah. Alright, so Lance went up a little bit more. We wanted to test Ruby's flexing with all the modifications, and damn, he's off just a little. So, but he's pretty good. Even he's tucked in here, but not touching. So actually, a 3.5-inch lift, Lance, a 3.5-inch lift would be.
I think we'd be good.
I think we're good. No 4.5. Yeah. So we're kind of testing it with the what do you call them? The body lift. What do you call those? Bump stop.
The body spacers.
Body spacers. We wanted to test it first. And it's been working out great today, and then seeing this, I think we will probably go with a 3.5-inch lift. Okay, so the first video was not disconnect the sway bars, and look at the difference. We wanted to show you the difference. We are touching now. That's the difference in the sway bars being disconnected and the flexibility. So we wanted to show that. Still have good flexing.
A little flexing.
For what we do, this makes us happy. Wow, that's an awesome photo. Look at that. That's pretty cool. That's what we want. So 3.5-inch lift will be in our future. I'm glad that we got a chance to put those bumps, whatever you call those stoppers in. I'll show you. It's called a body lift. Let me show you where they're at. If I can find them. Right here. That's what we put in. So we wanted to make sure that a 3.5-inch lift would be ideal for us. So we did the body lift, and that's what we're gonna do. She's looking great. So we're gonna head back to Moab.
What are you saying?
Open your mouth.
There's Todd.
I'm sorry, you did
it?
Yeah, it's all right.
Driver.
Yep, straight up. Alright, this is Todd and Kim's rig, which they got a really nice setup too. There's his Sahara Wrangler. He's put a lot of work and detail into this. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna come through this section here. Try to get some video of the Jeeps coming through. It's beautiful here. Beautiful. So. A rub. I couldn't tell. Here, heading back.
Dusty and dirty. Can't wait to jump in the shower.
Oh yeah.
We did. Oh, there's a pretty yellow bird. We did 30 miles in about 7 hours. So we were just barely crawling the whole time.
But it did not disappoint. We were in awe. I mean, just, I can't wait to put the video together. Hopefully it came together and do the photos. But it was amazing. And to spend it with Todd and Kim, our good friends, it just, we are truly blessed.
It was kind of cool. We spent last year with them. Schaefer Trail, which is on the other side of the Colorado River from where we were today, and today we got to do this side of the Colorado River with Todd and Kim again. So it was kind of fun. It was a different feel, even though it was just on either side of the river.
All right, so that was our day. Hopefully everybody enjoyed the video. We certainly did. We're going to go back and take some hot showers, probably rest a little bit, and then head into town for dinner. We might go to a Thai restaurant. We heard there's some really, really good.
And Chris from Really Quite Bright gave us a really good tip on this restaurant. He said it's the best Thai he's ever had.
Yeah.
So probably try that out.
All right, so we're going to let you go, guys. Keep on wheeling. Bye!